Welcome to the show. If you're just joining us, final hour, and it is action-packed. Let's start. Optus is under fire this morning with revelations the telco resisted calls to update its cybersecurity measures in the months before the hack. Up to 10 million people have had their data stolen, including Medicare numbers, passport details, driver's licences and email addresses.
The criminal came out yesterday and said they deleted the data. I'm personally normally a pretty glass half full guy, but I don't believe it. I don't trust criminals. That means this data is still out there. You can't put it back in that bottle.
Tougher laws could arise from the breach. The breach has sparked a state government response coast to coast. If your licence details have been compromised in the breach, here's what you can do. In Queensland, those impacted will be issued new licences with new numbers free of charge. Good thing. The same will take place in New South Wales, although customers will be forced to fork out a $29 service fee. Now, Optus will eventually cover those costs, but Lord knows how long you'll have to wait for that. Things are a bit more complicated in Victoria. There, you'll first have to flag your driver's licence with Vic Roads and request a replacement card. In South Australia, you can replace a driver's licence online using a MySagGov account. While over in WA, you'll need to get a police report number and go in person to gain a replacement licence, making it hard for them there in WA. More details on that soon. Sarah.
Yeah, a lot to get through there. Well, let's go to a Today weather alert. Multiple states have been lashed by wild weather overnight. A thunderstorm blitzed Sydney last night with 7,000 lightning strikes hitting between 2 p.m. and 6 a.m. today. Southeast Queensland was also battered by hail and heavy rain, causing power outages in Logan. Weather Zone's Ben Domenicino told Today on Nine more storms are expected this afternoon.
Over a broad area of New South Wales and Queensland, we'll continue to see thunderstorm activity today. This is a system that yesterday produced a funnel cloud, possibly even a tornado down near Deniliquin in southern New South Wales, and quite a bit of hail to the west of Sydney around the Blue Mountains. So we know that it's packing a bit of a punch and it's very unstable.
A former coach at the Hawthorn Football Club has compared the department to the Russian Mafia as explosive new allegations come to light. Chris Dennehearn joins us from Hawthorn HQ in Mulgrave. Chris, good morning. What more can you tell us?
Alex, former Hawks senior coach Alistair Clarkson and then assistant coach Chris Fagan have been accused of running the football department like the Russian Mafia, freezing out anybody that wanted to question their methods. This is coming from another former coach who has turned whistleblower. Those two coaches are also being accused of using bullying and intimidation against Indigenous players. All these allegations are being made in a report into the club's handling of Indigenous players. That full report has now been obtained by the Herald Sun. Other allegations include that two pregnant partners of players actually lost their unborn children during traumatic events, and that bullying in some instances was so bad that it amounted to human rights abuses. These are shocking claims, but they are unproven claims, and those are named in the report, which includes Alistair Clarkson and Chris Fagan, have vehemently denied any allegations of racism and have vowed to fight to clear their name. Alex.
Chris, thank you.
A Brisbane community is remembering a father of three after he was killed in a hit and run, allegedly by two teenagers in a stolen car. Today's Mia Glover is in Wynnum West in Brizzy. Mia, the government is being urged to crack down on youth crime.
Yeah, they certainly are, Carl. Here we go again. That is what the community is saying, and they're also calling for more and tougher laws for these young criminals. So many people that we've spoken to say enough is enough following the hit-and-run death of Michael Warburton. He is now the fifth victim in just 2 years of Queensland's youth crime crisis. This is a roadside vigil his friends and family have made for him. And as you can see, the community absolutely loved him. There's flowers, there's cards, there's also photos of him and his wife, Anita. They just celebrated their 33rd wedding anniversary just last month. He leaves behind three children as well, Carl. He was a tragic, big Penrith Panthers supporters as well. He was so excited that they were in the NRL Grand Final this weekend. But now his friends and family say they'll be supporting the Panthers in his memory. Now, the teenagers who have been charged over this, there's four of them in total, aged between 15 and 16. They faced court for the first time yesterday, but the media was barred from being in that courtroom. And the reason for that, the magistrate said, is because she was worried about their mental health.
It's time to act for Queenslanders now. Mia, thank you.
Anticipation for the NRL Grand Final is building ahead of the Battle of the Golden West this weekend, nowhere more so than in Penrith. Today, correspondent Lara Vella is with some very, very excited fans. Lara, good morning. Are they feeling confident? Back-to-back premierships,
Yeah.
Alex, feeling very, very confident, I'm sorry to say to you as a Parramatta supporter. Welcome to our second unofficial Penrith Panthers HQ. Guys, who do we go for down here?
Panthers!
This is Kathy's amazing home. Hasn't she done an incredible job, not only putting up all these decorations, but even hand-painting them and drawing herself? Kathy, what is it about the Penrith Panthers that you love so much?
Oh, I've been going for them for 40 years now, and they're homegrown. And, you know, we want to see them come home, bring the trophy home on Sunday, you know, because I've been supporting them for so long. So I'm so excited. And I knew the other day, and I said all week, if the man to bring it home was Api Korosau. And as soon as he went over, I knew we had it in the bag.
A little reassuring.
Absolutely, yeah, absolutely.
Are you proud of the boys?
Oh, absolutely, 100%. You know, everyone knows that I'm a very, very passionate Panther supporter.
You can't half tell by the house, can you?
No.
And Kathy, you've got a lot of family, cousins, friends watching in all parts of the country, everywhere from the Central Coast to outback New South Wales, even in Glebe. Who would you like to say hello to this morning?
I would like to say hello to Rab Trapman back home in Brewarrina. Hi, Rab. Loving you. And because I know you're 100% on this, and you've been waiting for this. I know you're so excited because you and I and Ange at the back here, we communicate every day, you know, and say good morning, Panther fans.
And that's what it's all about, isn't
absolutely.
It? Alex, there's so much community spirit, not just behind the Penrith Panthers, but of course the Parramatta Eels. It is so wonderful, this local representation, and to see so many of your family, your cousins, your neighbours out here. But I think if we got a little bit of a special delivery this morning, who is this?
Someone just pulled
is that
up.
A mini kick-out? And what's inside that sack, Kathy?
For me!
What if we got in here? A very special delivery from our mini kick-out.
Delivery
is that a Parramatta eel?
Oh my God!
What are you going to do with that Parramatta eel?
What are you going to do, everyone, on Sunday?
Yeah!
I love it.
Yes!
She's just tearing that eel apart.
We shall see.
Oh,
wow.
What a sweetheart.
Where's Brewarrina? Beautiful woman. She's from Brewarrina.
Brewarrina.
Where is that? Up past Walgett.
Where's that?
Up past Canamble.
Where?
Up past Dubbo.
Is that near Coonabarabran?
Near Coonabarabran.
I love it.
Up there in the northwestern beautiful part of New South Wales. Oh, wow.
I love it. Great colour.
How good are fans, eh?
Brilliant.
They are.
On Sunday night. All right. Thank you, Lara.